to Coast to Coast. I'm your host, Heather Dawson, and we are here at the Palm Springs International Film Festival, waiting for all the celebrities to hit the red carpet. What truly does this mean just for the impact of the city of Palm Springs?
It's really a game changer for our city.
Oh my gosh! What's up, Palm Springs?
I am so honored to get this award from Palm Springs Film International. This is one for the books.
At ICON, I never expected anybody to call me that. So it's lovely. It's a beautiful place. It's a great festival. So, yeah.
You know, I'm very flattered. It's a great honor, and it's the first time in Palm Springs, so it's all new to me.
Thank you so much to Palm Springs for this honor. This is very cool.
I love Palm Springs. Yeah. I actually had my bachelorette party in Palm Springs, so forever a big fan of Palm Springs.
This is such a fun festival. It's so close to LA. It's so easy to get to. Every time I come, though, I like want to stay for 5 days and get a massage because it's Palm Springs. Palm Springs will have a special place in my heart always.
The celebrities never disappoint. Here at the 35th annual Palm Springs International Film Festival, I'm your host, Heather Dawson for Coast to Coast. We'll see you next time. Tune in to Coast to Coast. I'm Heather Dawson.
And I'm Ava Lynn.
From the red carpet to your favorite travel destinations.
Where lifestyle meets inspiration.
Juan Pablo Arias Muñoz is a Chilean writer-director based in Los Angeles that was recently called by the LA Times as a true promise in the horror genre. This past month, he presented his latest short film, The History of Monsters, at AFI Fest 2019. He is coming to talk to us about his current work and future projects both in the U.S. and Chile. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
That is, I mean, quite an honor. I mean, you haven't been doing this for very long to be called out in the LA Times. How did that make you feel?
It was a surprise for sure. I mean, I've been developing my work on the horror for a while with shorts. Mm-hmm. But I mean, it's great to be called that without even having a feature, you know?
So what has drawn you to the horror genre?
It's one of the most special genres. I think it has some very interesting elements that I'm drawn to artistically. To me, it's the most challenging one, right next to comedy. I can't do comedy. That's like way too hard for me.
And also, you're a writer as well. So you're writing it, you're directing it, and it's beautiful, visionary. So what's in the future for you?
Yeah, so I have kind of my foot on writing TV and another foot on writing features.
I feel like now with all the streaming and there's just so many avenues, you know, to showcase your work, do you think that that's helping you as a writer-director versus, you know, 20 years ago when that wasn't an option, there were only certain channels?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the landscape of the industry is changing so much. I think it's mm-hmm. a great moment to be a writer-director, a creator of content, because there's so many new avenues, and you can tell that the industry is very hungry for new for new content. So as someone who just my work is to create that those stories, I think it's a great moment. As opposed to like 20 years ago when the technology wasn't as good and like you just had to rely on TV, like broadcasting or just the movies, like the big theater and studios. I think now equipment is cheaper. You can just create your own movies and you can put them on YouTube, and that's the least of the things you can do. And then up from there to like streaming platforms that are all looking for constant new shows, like the amount of money that Netflix or Disney Plus or Apple TV Plus are putting out there to make stories is very exciting.
So if anyone wants more information on how to see your film, where can they go?
So we're just starting our festival right now, so AFI Fest was our first stop, and the rest of the US for sure.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank
so we'll
much.
Have to have you back on in a year from now when we win your awards.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Thanks so much. Tune in to Coast. I'm Heather Dawson.
And I'm Ava Lynn.
From the red carpet to your favorite travel destinations.
Where lifestyle meets inspiration.
Well, it's that time of the year where we make a lot of financial resolutions, and one of those could be related to our FICO score. Well, here to tell us more about that is Jenelle Dito from MyFICO.com. Jenelle, why is it important that maybe at this beginning portion of the year to take a look at our FICO score?
Setting financial goals and being realistic about them is really important. Knowing your FICO score can help you set those realistic goals.
Now, how does our FICO score impact our financial decisions?
FICO scores are used by lenders to decide if they're going to approve your application, under what terms and rates. So it is really impactful into how you're planning for your budgets and your access to credit, how you're going to pay your tuition, how you're going to, you know, think about new cars, homes, any planning for unexpected expenses. The FICO score is a really important part of that.
Now, do we really need to strive for a perfect FICO score? I know everybody maybe works towards that, but is that truly an important thing to do?
It really is not. The perfectionists out there might not be able to let it go, but I would encourage everybody else to do so. High score is going to get you all those great rates. The higher is better, but there's nothing magical about having a perfect score. So,
now, what might be some of the simple steps that somebody can take to improve their FICO score?
So making sure you have access to your score. A lot of banks provide your FICO score on their online banking or in their apps. We provide it for free at myfico.com/free or in our MyFICO app. So know your score. And then when you understand your score, you can change your behaviors and impact your score positively. So paying your bills on time, that's always going to be the first piece and the most critical part. And avoid new applications. So don't take on new credit unless you really need it.
Now, we've all come off the Christmas and holiday spending spree, if you will. How do we essentially recover from that? I'm sure people may have overdone themselves, which is kind of typical for a lot of people.
Setting a budget, making a plan, and sticking to it. So really going after those payments, and being realistic about what you can put towards that budget and sticking to it. So being patient. Also going after those higher interest credit cards, those can make your budget dollars, you know, stretch a little further.
All right. Where can we learn more about our own personal FICO score?
We provide it for free at myfico.com/free or in that MyFICO app. And there's all kinds of information in there to help you get your FICO score, understand it, and understand all kinds of other credit education tips and financial health information.
For Coast to Coast, I'm J.R. Ibarra. Thanks for joining us.
Hey guys, I'm Jason Residlo, reporting from Huntington Place in downtown Detroit for the 2023 Detroit Auto Show. Come along with me as I check out some of the cool new cars, trucks, SUVs, and even flying vehicles. Yes, flying vehicles. The 2024 Jeep Gladiator made its premiere at the auto show. It will be available in four models: Sport, Willys, Mojave, and Rubicon. The refreshed truck comes with the new 7-slot grille, a new 12.3-inch touchscreen, and updated wheel options.
So with the new 2024 Gladiator, we're adding more capability, we're adding more refinement, more technology with a new standard 12.3-inch touchscreen radio, and more safety, including standard side curtain airbags, and standard adaptive cruise control and forward collision warning on the Sport S models and above.
Ford Motor Company took the wraps off the 2025 Mustang GTD supercar on the evening of Media Day. It is equipped with a 5.2-liter supercharged V8 engine producing more than 800 horsepower, but it's going to be pricey at around $300,000. Ford also unveiled the all-new 2024 F-150 hybrid pickup truck at Hart Plaza on Tuesday evening. It is now on display inside the Detroit Auto Show. The hybrid pickup comes with the new 2.7-liter EcoBoost engine with more horsepower and torque on its base model. One of the cool features on the new F-150 hybrid is the new Pro-Access tailgate that spins open like a door. In addition, Power Boost models can offer up to 7.2 kilowatts of power for tools and other accessories from an outlet in the truck bed. Tier 1 supplier Aisin told me more about their e-axles, which optimize energy efficiency and maneuverability, contributing to reduced energy consumption.
The efficiencies within the system are driven towards the range, and then complementary systems within the vehicle are driven for the aerodynamics off that electric base system. But our focus is on, from the electrification, is on the efficiency within the system, getting the power, extending the range within the components.
Aisin also displayed their wireframe demo car iMobility vehicle.
And you see some of the configuration and the constraints within the system for the suspension that comes into play. So the sizing of the unit and the packaging is very important, and it shows the importance here of that. But it's very similar. It's got the gearing inside. It's got a one-motor drive system, and it produces, in this particular application, it produces tractive force for the rear axle.
California-based Aleph Aeronautics introduced their Model A flying car. It can drive on the street, take off vertically, and even fly above the traffic. Public demonstrations are expected to begin in 2024, the company said. Cadillac showed off its refreshed 2025 CT5 luxury sedan. It comes with a brand new 33-inch diagonal LED color touchscreen display. The all-new 2024 GMC Acadia SUV is longer, wider, and taller than the previous model. The updates include a lower and wider front grille with redesigned Cadillac signature vertical lighting and stacked LED headlamps. It features a new 15-inch diagonal infotainment screen, available Super Cruise hands-free driver assistance feature. Attendees can enjoy free test rides in electric vehicles at the auto show.
It's got a range of up to 275 miles per charge. It takes about 30 minutes to charge the battery on a fast charger.
So this is all electric?
100% electric.
EVs by BMW, Chevrolet, Cadillac, Ford, Hummer, Tesla, and Volkswagen are available for free test rides in the back of Huntington Place. The Ram 1500 Revolution won the Izon Design Award for the best concept vehicle.
Special thanks to Ralph Hills, our leadership, who unfortunately had to go back for a meeting.
but I wanted to make sure that we brought up the Ram design team. So much passion went into this vehicle, and it's great to be recognized by our peers in the industry. So thank you all very much.
Meanwhile, the 2024 Ferrari Puro Sainz won the Aizen Design Award for Best Production Vehicle.
It was a project unlike anything we had ever undertaken at Ferrari before. And the fact that the design is being recognized by our peers for such a prestigious award is truly gratifying.
Chevrolet showed off its first ever hybrid Corvette sports car called the E-Ray. It comes equipped with a 6.2-liter small block engine producing 495 horsepower and an electric drive unit producing another 160 horsepower. The E-Ray will be the quickest Corvette ever, going from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 2.5 seconds. Pricing starts at $102,900 before destination charges. Startup company Joule Labs told me more about their robotic arm-enabled charging station system for autonomous vehicles. Their solution is perfect for rental cars and fleets, such as delivery vehicles.
These fast DC charging cables are extremely hard and they are very heavy. So this is a sort of ideal situation for ADA charging. But this solution is actually designed for automated charging for autonomous vehicles, like either autonomous ride-sharing services like Waymo or Cruise. It's ideal for automating charging for car rental companies. You know, car rental companies are electrifying their fleet, and then, you know, if you have to move a couple hundred vehicles per day, you have to charge them. It's actually quite simple.
Another company called NIFT, N-I-F-T, showed off their QB self-driving shuttle. It features an all-electric range of 30 miles with the top speed of 11 miles per hour.
We started it as a challenge, me and my kids, to build a driverless shuttle in 100 days from scratch. So we designed, built, and demonstrated a driverless shuttle. You can actually find us on YouTube under NIFT Go. And you can watch the full series of us building the shuttle from in our garage. Since then, we moved out of our garage, and we've moved into a space in Canton, Michigan, where we're doing electric vehicle development, along with several other vehicle-related hardware, software, and so forth. So this is an electric motor. Actually, this was actually built from a golf cart chassis. We restructured the chassis to actually fit this, and then we outfitted with sensors and actuators to actually be able to drive it autonomously. Or with an Xbox controller.
Other cool vehicles we spotted include the Volkswagen ID Buzz electric three-row microbus, along with the Rivian R1T and R1S electric vehicles. Bringing you the best of coast to coast, I'm Jason Residlo, reporting from the 2023 Detroit Auto Show.
Been here before, but this is the first time I'm spending more than 2 days. It's been usually very rush, and I love it. It's great weather, great. I mean, it's an amazing place.
I love it. It's beautiful. I wish I could stay here for a couple more nights. I'm definitely gonna come back.
I used to live here, and I love this. This is our vacation house, and of all the places we've ever sold a house, this is the only place we ever made a profit. So I think of it glowingly. I love Palm Springs. And I also, because this is the premiere of our movie, Thanks, and it's to have it premiere in the Palm Springs Film Festival is really very, very special.
This is like the Academy Awards or something. Look at all this. This is crazy. I know, I didn't know that. And the outlets are on the way home.
And that's a wrap here at the Palm Springs International Film Festival. Now it's time for all the award shows.